Dr. Hertzberg here, and welcome to our last chapel of the year. It's truly been a remarkable year in so many ways. We are so grateful for the Lord's goodness and faithfulness to us as a school, as families, to our students, to our faculty and staff. We have so much to be thankful for. As you know, our theme this year has been knowing Christ and making Him known. And our hope is that theme will continue to be the passion and the priority of your life far past this year. And as we look back on this year, my hope also is that it will not be marked with the great challenge of this last quarter, the COVID challenge, but we can look back with thanksgiving for all that our Lord has done, including this last quarter and the way that He continues to use that in all of our lives. Today we are going to be blessed to see a chapel that we had hoped to have in our wonderful auditorium, of course, and it's one of the highlight chapels of the year when each of the classes get to participate in our chapel. But today we have, through the hard work of Mr. Serb and Mrs. Swanson and Mrs. Quintero, a video montage or highlight of what has happened this last year, and especially in chapel and especially musically, as our students will get to participate from some of the youngest all the way to our oldest students that you will see here in the video. And just before I pray to commit this time to the Lord, just want to continue to challenge all of you as we go into the summer months to continue to read God's Word. Many of us took the challenge at the beginning of the year to read through the New Testament, and if you are continuing with that challenge, we're coming to the end of the book of Revelation, and I hope that you have continued to do that. But now as we go into the summer, I want to encourage you to do as we've done in the past, to read through the four Gospels, the first four books in the New Testament. And if that's too much, then consider reading the book of John, maybe a proverb along with that every day. But the important thing is to keep the Word of God running through your hearts and minds even this summer. Please join me now as we pray together. Father, we thank You so much for this day and for the opportunity to celebrate and to remember what You did through our students and through the various opportunities of this last year. Father, truly You have been so good and so gracious to us in so many ways, and we are truly, truly thankful, Lord. And we pray, Father, that You would continue to go before us as we go into the summer months. Lord, we pray that our love for You and our desire to know You and to make You known would continue to grow and increase and be the priority and the passion of our lives. Thank You for all that You've done, and we thank You, Lord, for every student and every family that is represented in our school. And we pray Your grace and Your blessing upon them. And we commit this time to You now as we pray this together in the holy name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Amen.
Look, everyone.
The angel appeared to the shepherds.
For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord.
Do you have room?
No, I have no more room.
Do you have room?
No, I just have a stable.
I think the baby's about to be born.
Oh, really?
A week later, Moses and Aaron returned to see Pharaoh.
The Lord God said, "Let my people go.
Let them go to worship God."
No!
When Pharaoh refused, Aaron did as God commanded. He stretched his rod over the rivers, lakes, and ponds. Thousands of frogs came hopping out. Frogs were everywhere. This was the second plague. Pharaoh told Moses that if God took the frogs away, he would let the Israelites go. So Moses prayed, and God took away all the extra frogs, but did
wrong trip. Because you are some of my most trusted servants, I am leaving you in charge of my wealth. Use these talents wisely, so when I return, you will have a good report.
Yes, sir. Ma'am.
You have been my most faithful servant, so I'm giving you 5 talents. Do not disappoint me.
Yes, ma'am. Master, you can count on me.
You too have been a good servant, so I'm giving you 2 talents. Do not let me down.
Yes, ma'am. I won't disappoint you.
You have been a fairly good servant, so I'm giving you 1 talent. Don't blow this or else.
Okay, whatever.
Hey, what about us?
Really? You've got to be kidding. You two barely even know how to tie your own shoes.
Spreading love with other people.
Knowing Jesus means kind words.
Knowing Jesus means not just knowing about him, but actually knowing him.
Knowing Jesus means being a Christian.
Knowing Jesus means praying to him.
Knowing Jesus means to know his personality and do stuff for him.
Knowing Jesus means to tell other people about Jesus.
I tell them about them. I tell them about God. I tell them about him, and I go to church.
Jesus is being kind.
Knowing Jesus means singing his praise.
Knowing Jesus means loving him.
Knowing Jesus means showing love towards others even when we are treated unfairly.
Knowing Jesus means showing love to others.
To me, God is my provider.
To me, God is my protector.
To me, God is my peace.
To me, God is my friend.
To me, God is my BFF.
To me, God is my helper.
To me, God is my rest.
To me, God is my hope.
To me, God is my comfort.
To me, God is my strength.
To me, God is my helper.
To me, God is my provider.
To me, God is my faith.
You
must pay the rent. You must pay the rent.
I can't pay the rent.
You must pay the rent. I'll pay the rent.
Tourette's foiled again.
We just memorized part of Psalm 136 in class, which talks about giving thanks to the Lord.
Yes, let's say it together. Audience, we'll say a phrase, and you say, "For steadfast love endures forever." When we point to you, you will say, "For steadfast love endures forever." Try saying your phrase in a count of 3. 1, 2, 3.
For steadfast love endures forever.
Good. Now please stand and say songs with us.
Psalm 136:1-12. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good. Give thanks to the God of gods. For steadfast love endures forever. Give thanks. above the waters.
Hello, folks. Welcome to What's in the Bible of 4th Grade. I am Jeffrey, your host. Today, we're going to teach you about the Pentateuch. The Pentateuch is the first five books of the Bible. It's also called Law. It's called Law because it's about law, like in the book of Exodus when the Israelites got the Ten Commandments. Oh, I almost forgot to introduce the newscaster of the show, Bucky Denver. And now, drum roll, please. Oh, come on, louder. Bucky Denver.
Thank you, Jeffrey. Hello, everyone, and welcome to What's in the Bible with Bucky Denver. Today we are learning about the Pentateuch. What is a Pentateuch exactly? Good question.
I like the Bible. It's not a fluke that it all starts out with the Pentateuch. Five little books that tell the story of God.
And Adam and Eve and Joseph and...
Sometimes called five books of Moses.
He's the one whose life composes.
The storyline of all these books, with the exception of Genesis. Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers.
Read a little every day before you slumber.
Cap it all off with a trip through Deuteronomy.
Deuteronomy, Deuteronomy.
Parts are fun, others not so much.
Riffs in and flung and plagues and such.
Whether you're German or French or Dutch,
we can all learn a thing from the Pentateuch.
That's not right. Whether you're a king or a queen or a duke,
we can all learn a thing from the Pentateuch. Genesis is the introduction.
Tells why the world has ceased.
Quite the way God intended it from the start.
From the start, from the very beginning.
Sin came in and made a mess up
all the ways God was gonna bless us.
Because we did not trust him with all our hearts.
We like the Bible, it's not a fluke. It all starts out with the Pentateuch. Five little books that tell the story of God.
And Eve and Adam and Joseph and...
Whether you're a king or a queen or a duke,
we can all learn a thing from the Pentateuch.
Before we get to Matthew,
don't ever, ever forget that God has a master plan for your life. He will provide the right tools and the master plan when you face difficulties.
When you face many trials of many kinds, you can praise him with songs and psalms like David did.
I raise a hallelujah in the presence of my enemies. I raise a hallelujah.
Strength and speed will not help anyone to hear the right flute.
The king asked the question that was on everyone's lips.
And how did you hear my song?
I chose the right companion.
Oh my gosh!
It was the prince. In his hand, he carried the flute.
I knew there is only one other person who could play your song exactly like you. There was no one else I would have trusted to be with me all the way. So I asked him to come with me. As we journeyed, he played your song. I learned it so well that even though 1,000 false flutes tried to hide your music, I heard yours above them all. It was with me all the way.
Never had the knights heard such soothing music.
My father's flute plays the same song. His song will guide you to the castle.
This year, the fifth grade memorized the entire chapter of Isaiah 53. Here is Mrs. Doyle's class sharing verse 5 from that amazing chapter about Jesus. Isaiah 53. But he was pierced for our transgressions, he was crushed for our iniquities. The punishment that brought us peace was on him, and by his wounds we are healed.
On Thursday for Service Learning Week, we did two things. The first thing we did was go to Techni Towers. We talked with the fathers, and we also made headbands for women and girls in Guatemala. This helps serve others by making people feel loved. Talking to the fathers gave them company. Making hair accessories for little girls made them feel loved. My takeaway was this: make people feel loved. This inspired me so much that day that I invited a girl who was sitting alone to sit with me at lunchtime. Always make people feel loved because it will make you feel happy too. My Bible verse was, "A new commandment I give to you, that you love one another just as I have loved you." God tells us to love one another. On that day, we loved others that we didn't even know. We obeyed God's commandment, and I encourage you to love others too. Loving others makes you happy.
We remember these boys, who in life many of us saw as rank rascalities, well deserving of the cowhide. We saw only faults and flaws, but this blinded us to the truth, that those boys, each of those poor, lost, dead boys, possessed a sweet and generous nature. Many episodes that involve what we saw as aggravating and irksome behavior in the light of their tragic and untimely death, are now seen clearly as noble and beautiful moments to be cherished in our memories for the many years to come. Yes, those poor, poor, dead, innocent angels.
Suddenly, there was a rustle in the gallery.
The minister stopped. First one,
and then another pair of eyes followed the minister's.
And almost with one impulse, the entire congregation stood staring
as the three dead boys came marching down the aisle.
Who is God the Lord Almighty? Well, hello, CHA. We've come to the end of the year. Can you believe it? It's been a wild ride, and who would have thought we would have ended the year like this? But here we are. And I first want, before I close in prayer, I want to acknowledge those of precious people who are leaving us. For those seniors who are moving on to a new season in life, God bless you. May the Lord bless your plans. May you always follow Him. And to the families who are leaving and have no more children at CHA, we want to say, may the Lord be with you as well. And then finally, for those families, for whatever reason that you are not returning to CHA, God bless you. We will miss every single one of you. And we do pray that the Lord would richly bless all your plans and watch over you. So take care. Let's go ahead and let's close in prayer. Father, thank you for this year. Thank you that you knew ahead of time what was going to happen during this year, that nothing was a surprise to you. We're grateful that you are in control, that you love us dearly, and that you walk with us. Would you go with each family as we go into the summer? Keep us safe. Lord, for those returning, would you bring all of these families, these precious people, back to us safely and healthy? And for those that are moving on to a different season that does not include CHA, would you bless them as well and watch over them? Lord, we give you this summer. Oh, may we be able to enjoy being outside. We ask that you would heal our nation and this world from the illness that has so prevailed. We love you and thank you that our security rests in you because of what Jesus has done for us, in whose name we pray. Amen. CHA, have a wonderful, wonderful summer break. We will miss you, and we hope to see so many of you again in September, actually in August. God bless you. Bye-bye.
Let me hear the worshipers!